What is up, guys? It is that one Taco Bell guy. I am back on this YouTube game. I will be uploading videos every Tuesday from now on. And the first one is going to be a remake of an old video I made, which is about my first-person rig. Here it is. I've updated it a little bit, and plus just making this a little bit of better quality, because I shot that on my dad's old camera, and I didn't know how to use it, so it came out shitty because of me, not because of the camera. Alright, so let's get right into it. This was used on my short called Escape, which you can watch right here. I'll also link in the link below. Like I said, it's pretty much a first-person rig. I'm gonna need my glasses for this because of the way the rig works, pretty much. Since the camera is right here, it's supposed to kind of rest on your eye. That's not very comfortable, plus you kind of need some support right here, just a bit further out from the eye, to make it just a bit more stable and to make it not fall off your head every like 5-10 minutes when you're running. So if you don't wear glasses, I suggest having like a cloth or something, put it right on your eye, because you're not gonna be able to see anything with this eye anyways if you use a camera like this. So pretty much you just put it on, and like I said, it rests on your glasses here, or a cloth if you decide to put something there, and you pretty much just go around walking around recording stuff. It's pretty cool. Works great for first-person action shooters, like I said. I'll show the video I made with it. Alright, so let's get into the build. So, first off, a note. This most likely will not work with DSLRs because they are pretty big, and it puts the screen way too close to your head. I've tried this out with my little Olympus camera. I'll show you a picture of it here if I haven't showed it off before. Here you go. It's waterproof. It's pretty nice, but since it's like, you know, like DSLRs, there's a screen on the back. It doesn't flip out. It's too close to your face to actually for you to be able to view, you know, because your eye can't focus that close onto that thing that's right in front of your face. It's very weird the way that works. So the reason this is good, like I said, is because the screen flips out and it's like all the way out in front, even in front of the cap part, so your eye can more easily focus onto it. This part up here is just for more stabilization. If you didn't have this, the front part of the cap would just hang down lower and lower, and you do not want that. You want it to be even and nice. Now, the way I built this, originally I used a guitar string, which, if you'll notice in my regular video, is not a very good idea because it kept on scratching against the little nut right here. I'm sorry, the bolt, and just kept on making a lot of noise. But I glued this in place with hot glue. Now, note to yourself, never ask me to work with hot glue for you because I tend to make a mess. And sorry, I figured I shouldn't clean this up because it's just for bullshit projects. I do nothing professional. But yeah, like I said, I just put three zip ties together, tied it together, saw, you know, how tight I needed it to be. And if you don't glue this together, pretty much what will happen is this front part will come scrunched up together like this, so it'll be even more comfortable to put on your head. And it'll be falling off easily because the back part will be up higher and just want to fall down. If you do that, if you hot glue it like this, or use any type of glue, you can put the back part of your hat further back, therefore giving it more stabilization, and it's less likely to fall off your head. And another thing, I also suggest having a cap that has a adjustable back part for me if you're going to use it with other people. You know, other if you can use other actors for it. You can either use this, like the Velcro one, which is the easiest one, or you can use the one with the little holes, whatever you call that, those caps. So those are really the best ideas for it. So yeah, and like I said, just to repeat myself again, just to stress this, it works best with these kind of cameras that have a screen that flips out, because it gives it further away from your eyes so I can better focus onto it. So that's all for today's video, guys. Thanks for watching, and next week will be a video about shoulder rigs. I'll do a test footage comparison of shooting handheld versus a DIY shoulder rig versus a real professional shoulder rig for a thing that costs about $200. Now, the DIY rig that I made, it's actually based off of a design that a YouTuber by the name of KnopTop made. The guy's really good. I love all our stuff. I've been following him for a while. Click right here to subscribe to him somewhere if you'd like. Go check out the videos, build videos. I'll link him again in the next week's video as well. So, like I said, it'll be a video comparing handheld versus DIY versus professional gear. So if that topic is something that interests you, tune in next week to watch the video, and I will see y'all later.